We want to evaluate the indefinite integral using the method of substitution. When using the method of substitution, we let part of the integrand function be equal to u such that u prime resembles the remaining part of the integral. We might be thinking we should let u equal the denominator of 2 plus e to the power of negative 3x. So if we try this, the next step would be to determine differential u, or differential u or du, equals a derivative of u times dx, which is 0 plus e to the negative 3x times negative 3 times dx, or negative 3 e to the negative 3x dx. But this substitution is not going to work, because notice if we let u equal the denominator, we're left with 3dx, and we have du equals negative 3 e to the negative 3x dx. So because of this extra factor of e to the negative 3x, this u substitution is not going to work. However, we can change the form of the integrand function so that we then can perform u substitution. Let's start with the given integrand function, which is f of x equals 3 divided by the sum of 2 and e to the power of negative 3x. And let's multiply the numerator and denominator by e to the positive 3x. This will give us a factor of e to the 3x in both the numerator and denominator. Multiplying in the numerator, we have 3 e to the 3x divided by the sum of 2 e to the 3x. And notice e to the negative 3x times e to the positive 3x is equal to e to the power of 0, because when multiplying in the bases of the same, we add the exponents, and e to the 0 is equal to 1. Which means we can write the original integral as the integral of 3 e to the positive 3x divided by the sum of 2 e to the 3x and 1. In this form, we can let u equal the denominator and use the method of substitution. So now we'll let u equal the denominator of 2 e to the 3x plus 1. Now we determine du, which equals u prime times dx, which gives us 2 e to the 3x times 3, applying the chain rule, plus 0 times dx, which indicates du equals 6 e to the 3x dx. And now we compare u and du to the given integral. We know the denominator of 2 e to the 3x plus 1 is equal to u, and we're left with 3 e to the 3x dx, and we have du equals 6 e to the 3x dx. Notice if we divide both sides by 2, the right side will be a perfect match of 3 e to the 3x dx. So let's go ahead and divide both sides by 2, which indicates 1 half du equals 3 e to the 3x dx, which means we can now substitute 1 half du for 3 e to the 3x dx. Next, we write the integral with respect to u. Again, 3 e to the 3x dx equals 1 half du. Let's go ahead and factor out the 1 half du. We know the denominator is equal to u, and therefore the integrand function is now just 1 divided by u. Next, we integrate with respect to u, and then write the antiderivative back in terms of x. Recall the integral of 1 divided by u du equals natural log absolute value of u plus c, which means in our case, the antiderivative with respect to u is equal to 1 half times natural log absolute value of u plus c. And now we substitute 2 e to the 3x plus 1 for u. And because 2 e to the 3x plus 1 is always non-negative, we can drop the absolute value and write the final antiderivative as 1 half times natural log of the quantity 2 e to the 3x plus 1 plus c. This is the family of functions whose derivatives are all equal to the given integrand function. I hope you found this helpful.